Welcome back to the channel. Today's video, I wanted to show you guys how to address dirt that's in a whole scene. On a previous video, I showed you how to just isolate a defect or two, but I had a commenter ask about how to do a longer shot or a full clip. So let's check that out. So here we have the Fox logo. And if we play it, you can see this one's pretty dirty, pretty trashed. A lot of dirt, hair, artifacts, emulsion stains, scratches. Pretty tore up. So now, if we show you the cleaned up version, I only used a couple tools, and this is the results that we have. So it's not perfect by any stretch, but it's cleaned up significantly from the original. So let's jump in, I'll show you how to do that. So I took this clip over to the color page, and we have two nodes enabled. First one, I'm using automatic dirt removal. So in your effects library under Resolve Effects Revival, it shows the automatic dirt removal. For the other example, I used this dustbuster tool and I did a film splice where it was like a singular kind of stain at the bottom and you could draw around it and it would replace it that way with some surrounding pixels. This automatic dirt removal does more of a global cleanup. So I just dropped that onto the first node, and if we go into our settings, I'll walk you through what it's doing. So first and foremost, we have motion estimation type. I did switch that to better. It just works a little bit stronger. Use a little more resources, but it does a better job. Neighboring frames here is how it's looking at the surrounding frames to make up the fix. So if a frame has something on it, it'll look at a frame before, a frame after, in this case, two frames, and try to do an average of what those frames look like to fill in the defect. Repair strength is just how strong the tool is. I think I dialed it back just a hair to look and see how it was working. And then we have dirt size threshold. So depending on the level of dirt, or you might have something that's just not as bad as this, you could either raise the threshold or lower it, and it'll work a little smoother and cleaner based on that setting. Now, this will make me re-render this. As you can see, both these nodes have a little blue icon, and that means the cache is rendered. It correlates to right here, your render cache. So I'm going to show you the repair mask here. If we click on that, it sort of turns it into a highlight, and if we scrub through, you can see these little white spots. That's where it's going to try to repair. So this is letting you know what it's seeing as a problem as far as dirt goes. This will let you know as you're dialing in your settings what it's actually looking at, and then you can click that off and it'll go back to your default view. Now you have fine controls, which is a motion threshold, and edge ignore. Motion threshold is just going to be like what is actually active. Maybe you got an action shot, something with some more motion blur and a lot of things going on. That will dial that in with that parameter so it will know what to work on and not get confused as much. The edge ignore is kind of where two things intersect. If it needs to sort of feather that out and it's maybe two high contrast points that join together, this will smooth that out. I ended up leaving these alone because it was just doing a good job as is. So depending on what your source is, you're going to have to adjust some of those. And then global blend I left on because there's no reason to kind of split the difference on this effect. I wanted it to be a full transparent effect. So you can think of automatic dirt removal node as the general cleanup. So this gets rid of all the scratches, the dirt, all that kind of stuff. Node number two, I'm using as a visual cleanup. So over here, I moved over to our motion effects. And under there, I believe this is a studio only feature, we have some controls. So I had it on two frames, motion estimate type better, range medium, and then our temporal threshold. You can deselect the luminance and chroma. I left them linked and just brought it up to a 1.6 to where I could see some smoothness in the image where it's getting rid of some of the grain and things like that. So you can think of this one as your global cleanup. And the second one, feeding into this after the dirt's clean, it'll do a little bit of smoothing out. You don't have to use that, but it does make it look a little nicer. Now we'll go back and we'll do a little bit of before and after on a couple of these. Keep in mind, as you can see, we got this red line back. That's our playback render cache. If you resize a clip, make a color adjustment, anything like that, and these need to re-render, anytime you're going to do that, it's going to have to cache everything out once again for you to get real-time playback. Keep that in mind. So the automatic dust busting is going on node one, and the temporal noise reduction is going on node two. We could add another downstream node, but if it's prior to this or back on the edit page and we make some kind of adjustment like transform or something like that, or cropping, it's gonna have to re-render everything. So now let's go ahead and turn back our original and we'll go through and we'll just look at some of these problems right here and just see what it did. So as you can see, almost every frame's got something bad on it. There's a little bit of film warp and things like that. Here's a giant hair up here and quite a few negative stains right here. And if we look on the new version, you can see pretty much gone. And there's a few other stains and scratches too. Here's one just over the spotlights. And if we get rid of the original, you can see that one's pretty cleaned up as well. There's a nice emulsion stain. If I can find it again, hang on. So this one's kind of bogging down because I have the second clip doing all this work. Yeah, here we go. So we have this emulsion stain right here. And if we turn on the new version, it pretty much took care of it. So that's about it. Only a couple tools. I believe they're studio only. So if you don't have studio, this is just yet another batch of reasons that it's worth buying. One-time purchase fee. At the time, I don't know if they're going to change that model or not, but you buy a license and I've had mine for a few years now and it's continual upgrades thus far. All right, if you guys have something you're trying to work on and you would like me to take a stab at something similar and solve something, make a fix, maybe how I would approach it, leave a comment down below. I always look for your guys' comments. They give me good ideas on content. So feel free to leave one if you got something you're working on or you got how do you do this kind of question. I'll keep an eye, and if it's something that looks pretty good, I'll make a video on that. So that's about it for this video. Thank you for watching. As always, subscribe if you haven't. I really appreciate it, and I'll talk to you guys on the next one.